Now next, latent heat of vaporization. This is also very very important. So what is latent heat? Hidden heat. Vaporization, liquid changing to gas. So what is latent heat of vaporization? The amount of heat energy required to convert 1 kg of liquid. The amount of heat energy required to convert 1 kg of liquid into gas at atmospheric pressure at its boiling point. Here boiling point, because it is latent heat of vaporization. Vaporization means liquid to gas. So here boiling point, this is called latent heat of vaporization. You can compare it with latent heat of fusion. Fusion means melting. Vaporization means melting, means solid to liquid. Vaporization means liquid to gas. So a slight change only in the definition, latent heat of fusion and latent heat of vaporization. Look here, the amount of heat energy required to convert, till here it is same for latent heat of fusion and latent heat of vaporization. The amount of heat energy required to convert, if it is latent heat of vaporization, to convert what? 1 kg of liquid into gas. Because it is vaporization, to convert 1 kg of liquid into gas. And if it is latent heat of fusion, fusion means melting. Melting means solid to liquid. So there what will be the definition? The amount of heat energy required to convert 1 kg of solid into liquid. Clear? Only this difference is there. At atmospheric pressure, both same for both the definition. At atmospheric pressure, at its, if it is fusion, latent heat of fusion, at its melting point. Now it is latent heat of vaporization. So at its boiling point is called latent heat of vaporization. Clear? Now example, latent heat of vaporization of water is 2259 kilojoule per kg. Means to convert 1 kg of water completely to water vapor. To convert 1 kg of water completely to water vapor, how much heat energy is required? 2259 kilojoule heat energy is required once the boiling point is reached. Means once the water reach 100 degrees Celsius, after that to convert water completely into water vapor, how much heat energy is required? 2259 kilojoule heat energy is required. And this you do not see rise in temperature in the thermometer, it is hidden. So for what this heat energy is used, this much heat energy? It is used to overcome the interparticle force of attraction in liquid and to convert it into gas. Overcome the interparticle force of attraction in liquid and to convert it into gas. So liquid, which is liquid example we have given? Water. To change it completely into water vapor or steam. Clear?